Hello, today we are going to learn how to apply for self-assessment and payment for property tax for NKDA. Okay, so at first you have to open the website, NKDA website, that is the NKDAMAR.org. Just open it from your computer and click it. Okay, so you will get this pop-up, and here a short notice has been displayed. Okay, you can see that apply for self-assessment tax and payment for property tax, register, login, file self-assessment and pay the tax. So these are the simple steps which has been shown here, but those who don't know about these things, for them only I am making this video. Okay, and the last date is 2nd June. So do it as soon as possible, and the helpline number is already given here, but I doubt because I have called there a lot of times but nobody received my call. So that's why it will be better if you see this video and pay your tax online. Okay, so just click here. Okay, and after that you will be redirected to this page. So just click apply for self-assessment tax. Okay, so you haven't registered in this website till now, so that's why you have to do the registration. That is, so you have to click here, citizen registration. Okay, if you have already registered, then you just put your username and password and the captcha and click the login button. But I doubt, because this is the new, you know, who are living in NKDA, under the NKDA or new town. They are paying the property tax first time, so that's why I doubt they have any user ID or password. So just click the registration, citizen registration. A pop-up will be there. Now you have to put the user type, that is a citizen. Username, put your username, anything. It's maybe your name, just like I'm just giving an example. Just like this, your full name, give your full name. If I am taking an example, it's not my name actually. Password, take your password as per your choice. Okay, confirm your password. After that, password hints, take some password hints. If you forgot the password, then using this password hints question, you can you can get back your password. So please take this, just like this, your what is your mother maiden name. So please, this is the options given here. Give your mobile number over where you will you want to get the information over the property tax. So just put that mobile number over here. Give your email ID and put your address, the address where you are living right now, and after that click the save button. Okay, now I have completed my registration, and the username, full name is already showing here. You can take a printout of those of this, okay, for your future reference. Now my account has been created, so I have to log in using my user ID and password. Okay, so I have been I have logged in. Okay, so now you have to click this. Okay, so we are going to pay our self-assessment tax. So at first we have to assess our property at first, so you have to click it at first. NKDA, you can check that there are a lot of departments over there, so you have to click it here. Assessment of property tax at NKDA. Okay, so there are some details, you know, documents required, whatever is given here, proof of relation property which has been submitted. So these things you have to submit. At last I will give you those references. Now just follow me. Apply. Okay, so date of completion or possession or purchase of the property. So when you have purchased that property, give that date. For me, I am taking this as January 2, 2016. Okay. So now you have to fill up details of entity filing assessment return. So you have to fill up those things, you know, the owner of the name of the owner of the property. So if it's Mr., then select the Mr. and the name, put the last name. I'm saying it once again, this is not my name, I am just giving it as an example. This is not a real person. I don't know any person named Manish Day. This is a fictitious character. Okay. Date of birth. Put your date of birth over here. Gender male. Put your mobile number over there. This is the mandatory field. Okay, so put your mobile number over there and please validate it. You have to put your mobile number over here. Just I am giving you an example. This is not my mobile number, I am just giving you an example. So just put it over here and after that you have to validate it. How to do that? Click it. You will get an OTP in your phone. Okay, so just put that OTP over here and click the submit button and your mobile number will be validated. After that you have to put your email ID. Aadhaar card number is not mandatory. If you want to give it, then you can do that. Nationality Indian, obviously. Relationship of the property, present owner. And PAN number is mandatory, so just put your PAN number over here. Address of the property and the address for which you are going to pay the property tax. So you have to put that address over here. So if your property in action area 1 or action area 2 or action area 3, then you have to put that details. Okay, so I am giving an example from action area 3. So I am selecting the action area 3. Premises number, plot number. So this may be a confusion for you. From where you will get that? Okay, so to get these things, I have to go back and tell you from where you will get these things. Okay, so in NKDA website, when you have clicked it, nkdaema.org, okay, when you have clicked it, you have got this page. Okay, this pop-up. When you have clicked it, you have got this page and we have started from by clicking here. Okay, but in the left side you will get a lot of details: property tax, list of documents submitted, maps and area. So from there, here you will get the plot and premises. 1 minute, let me check it. Yes, find your plot and premises number, this. So click it. Okay, after clicking this, you will get these details: plot number. You can check plot number and premises number. Okay, action area 1, premises number is this. Action area 2, premises number is this. Action area 9, premises number is this. Okay, so for me, if I am living some apartments, you know, some towers or some society, then those things are already given here. You can check that. Animika housing is the plot number is this and the premises number is this. For my example, I am giving one example from New Town Heights. Okay, so New Town Heights, for New Town Heights, the plot number is IIE by 5. that is action data 3 e by 5 and the premises number is this. So just copy this. And put it here. Okay. Yes. So whenever you will put these details, the plot number will be filled up automatically. Okay. So select the pin number. The pin code is for me it will be 700156. Country, state, the district is South Chabbis Pargana. Okay. And the southern will be filled up automatically whenever you will select this South Chabbis Parganas. Rural or urban, urban, development authority, NKDA, police station is New Town. Address of the property, from here you have to put the address of your property. Like me, if I am giving the address of the particular property for which I am going to pay the property tax, it's just like this. Flat number, put the all details, whatever the details of your flat, put that details. I'm just giving an example, XYZ. Okay. Okay, so now you have to check the area code. Area code, how to check this? You have to click here, find your area code. You can check action area 3 IIE, action area 3E. All the plots of action area 3E is under F. F, area number F. Okay, action area 3E is under E. Action area 3, all plots of action area, sorry, action area 2E is under E category, E area, and action area 3, for my case, action area 3E is under F area. So I have to select F. Okay, I have filled up all these things, and now some things are there which I have to fill up, you know, and I will do that myself. PAN number, etc, etc. You have to do it yourself. So after that, click the save button. Okay, so now after filling up that portion, when you click the save and next button, you will be redirected to this page. So this is the communication address of the applicant. Okay, so if the address is same as your you know, the last address whichever you have provided there, so just click here, just click here. Okay, and if it's not same as per given last details, I mean for which address you are going to pay the property tax, then you have to fill up it once again, I mean as per your communication address where you are living right now. It may be under NKDA, it may not be under NKDA, that's not an issue. Okay, for in my case it's the same address, so that's why I am giving it same as the previous address. Okay, now details of the tax sathi. So if you have spoken with anyone else, I mean some tax sathi through call, phone calls, then you have to give that details here. If you have spoken with someone else, then just put it yes, and the name of the tax sathi, you know, and the enrollment number. I haven't spoken with anyone, so that's why I'm selecting no. Okay, so type and location of the property. Type of the property is the list is given here. In my case, it's a flat, so I am selecting apartment or flat or appointed unit. Select it as per your choice. I mean, whatever your case is, this you can select that. You know, location, property attributed by roads having width up to 20 meter. For my case, this is the thing, so that's why I am selecting it. this things is not required, so that's why you can click over here. Total coverage area including open or covered garage. So if you have some garage, then just total, calculate the total area and put it over here. For my case, it's near about 100 square feet total, sorry, 1000 square feet. It's for residential unit, it's a residential unit, so that's why I'm selecting it residential. And over here you have to put the details of the property. Before filling it up, you can check, you can click this, okay, you can click this and you will get the details, what are the information you have to fill it here. You can click it and then PDF file will be there, that will be downloaded, and just go through that. For my case, I am selecting it like this. Flat, covered area is 900, age of the property 10 years or less, structure, it is under MIG or LIG, residential unit or non-residential unit, in a HIG units and commercial units. Residential purpose, occupancy, owner occupied. Add. So I have open garage, so I have to select this, okay. Occupancy, owner occupied. Add. So I have added the details. Now, other details. You don't have this accessi number, so you, because we are just registering ourselves, okay, so this number is not required. If you select yes, then you have to put it over here. We are not registered, so that's why no. If you are a central government employee, then you have to click it yes. If no, then no. I accept, and after that save and next. After clicking the save and next button, you will get this page. This is the application details for assessment of property tax at NKDA. You will be given an application number, so just check these things. If you have done some mistake, some errors, then click the edit button and correct it. You have made some mistake in this application, then click this edit application button and correct it. Now you have to attach some supporting documents, just like your ID proof and supporting documents of the property. Okay, so just click here. You can take the printout of these things, you know, the filled up form, you can take the printout of this as well. So attach the supporting documents, just click over here. And you will be redirected to this page. So proof identity, so just click it. The file size should be 150 KB and JPG image format. So just click and put it here and click the save and next button. Okay, so by this, the supporting documents will be provided online. Okay, so when you click the draft application, okay, you will get this. Okay, this is your application ID and you will get these details. So what you have to do, you have to submit your supporting documents, what I have said. So just submit those supporting documents, and after submitting that, your application will be approved and you will get your application status, approved application status. When you click this portion, you will get your application ID and EIN number over there, and you will get the XSC number also. So with that, with those numbers, you can track your application from here. You have to give put the application identification number, that is the EIN number, and the registration number, section number, or assessment number. So that will be provided after submitted your application with the supporting documents. Okay, so you will get those things after that, and whenever you will put those numbers over here and click the search application button, you will get your application. You can see your application, you know, and you will get the payment link over there as well. When you click that, you will get a payment link over there, and the tax details also, whatever the total tax amount, you will get those details also. Just click that and click the pay button over there. Select the payment mode, that is the credit card or net banking, whatever. I will suggest you to pay using your credit card because that would be more safe. So just pay that amount, and after paying that amount, you will get the e-receipt. Take the printout of that e-receipt, and you can save it as a PDF format in your laptop as well. So this is the total procedure. Okay, I am telling you, if you have any doubt, then you can comment here, and I will give you the answer as soon as possible. Okay, thank you guys, and please subscribe my YouTube channel. Click the like button if you like my video, and click the bell icon, and pay your property tax as soon as possible. Thank you so much.